الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم ألهمنا مراشد أمورنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. At the end of Surah Kahf, Almighty Allah indicated towards when Almighty Allah wants a revolution to take place in the world, He creates men for that revolution. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ قُلْ سَأَتْلُوا عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْهُ ذِكْرًا. They will ask you regarding the individual known as Zul Qarnayn. And the details of Zul Qarnayn Almighty Allah would mention. In the details would the main part or the main point would be Inna makkanna lahu fil ard. Indeed we gave him power on the earth. Wa ataynahu min kulli shay'in sababa. Whatever he needed, we would make it. We would make the arrangements for it to come to him. When Almighty Allah desires a revolution, preparations beforehand, if man looks, he finds nothing. It will happen suddenly. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke about the revolution of Islam. The coming of Sayyidina al-Mahdi radiyallahu anhu will be sudden. The coming of Nabi Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will be sudden. Around the world, if someone is looking for some sign, he will not find that sign. In the surah after Surah Al-Kahf, Surah Maryam, indication is made towards this very point. That at times when no one can see how help is going to come, how aid is going to come, how a man who will create the revolution is going to stand. He finds that if this man has to even make a call at the moment, where will he find his support? Where will he find his help? Where will this man come from? The beginning of the surah, Kaf ha ya ain sad, dhikru rahmati rabbika abdahu zakariya. This is the mention of how the mercy of your Lord fell upon his slave Zakariya alayhi salam. At a very old age, Zakariya alayhi salam makes a dua. Rabbi inni wahana al-azmu minni. Oh Allah, my bones have become weak. Washta'ala ar-ra'su shayba. My hair has become white. Walam akum bidu'aika rabbi shaqiyya. He says, but it has never been, oh Allah, that I asked you ever for something except that you gave it. You have never ever left me empty-handed from my du'as. وَإِنِّي خِفْتُ الْمَوَالِيَ مِنْ وَرَائِي وَكَانَتِ امْرَأَتِي عَاقِرًا. He says, my wife has become barren. And I have a fear that the people who I'm going to leave behind, without a guide, how will they manage? فَهَبْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ ذُرِّ وَلِيَّا. He said, O Allah, from your side, will you send someone to help me? يَرِثُنِي وَيَرِثُ مِنْ آلِ يَعْقُوبِ. He can be the inheritor of me, meaning he can take this work of nubuwah. He can inherit from the family of Yaqub alayhi salam. وَجْعَلْهُ رَبِّ رَضِيَّ. يَا زَكَرِيَّا إِنَّا نُبَشِّرُكَ. Almighty Allah informed him that you asked for a helper. The helper will be your very own son. We give you the glad tidings of a child whose name will be Yahya. لَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ مِنْ قَبْلُ سَمِيًّا. Before him, we had not given this name to anyone, or we have not given the qualities he will have to anyone. Nabi Yahya alayhi salam was born unique, most chaste and most pure. قَالَ رَبِّ أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي غُلَامٌ. Almighty Allah's Qudrat brings shock and amazement even to the Anbiya alayhimus salam, on whose hands miracles will take place. Miracles took place. But even they would show amazement at the Qudrat of Almighty Allah. When Almighty Allah gave Yahya alayhi salam to Zakariya alayhi salam at an age where Zakariya alayhi salam felt it's impossible for a husband and a wife at this age to get a child. But the Qudrat of Almighty Allah, he asked, Anna yakunu li ghulam. How will a child come to me? Whereas my wife is barren. وَقَدْ بَلَغْتُ مِنَ الْكِبَرِ عِتِيًّا. And I have also reached a very old, advanced age. What an amazing answer was given. قَالَ كَذَلِكَ. It will happen just like that. رَبُّكَ هُوَ عَلَيَّ هَيِّنَ. Your Allah says that everything is easy for your Allah. وَقَدْ خَلَقْتُكَ مِنْ قَبْلُ. Did not Allah create you before this? And you were also nothing. When Almighty Allah decides to make a person, an individual, stand, even if the halat and the conditions around are not muwafiq, there is no sign, there is no, like you will say, a king was there, now it will be the prince. He already has soldiers who are tabi', who are obedient to him. He already has a lot of wealth at his disposal, a lot of arms at his disposal. He is known in the world. Such a man will stand. He can create a revolution. When Sayyiduna al-Mahdi will come, he will have no support around him. He will have no previous connections. Almighty Allah makes indication how Yahya alayhi salam came as an aid to Zakariya alayhi salam, when even Zakariya alayhi salam could not find it possible for him and his wife to get a child. More higher than that, more amazing than that, Almighty Allah gives then the incident of Maryam radiallahu anha. And on this the surah has its name, Surah Maryam. That her incident is even more amazing. When the world needed someone to stand with a revolution, then the normal system of the world is for every child to come in the world, you need a mother and a father. You need them of the correct age. Zakariya alayhi salam and his wife were out of that age. Almighty Allah showed, even out of the age, out of a season, Almighty Allah can give a fruit. With Maryam radiallahu anha, there was a woman, but there was no husband with. There was a female, there was no male. Almighty Allah was going to show, out of season he can give a fruit. Even without the tree, Almighty Allah can create the fruit. وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ. Now make mention of Maryam. إِذِ انْتَبَذَتْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا. When she moved away from her family, مَكَانًا شَرْقِيًّا. She went to an eastern corner. فَاتَّخَذَتْ مِنْ دُونِهِمْ حِجَابًا. She established a barrier, a parda. Ulama say that she had gone to take a ghusl. She had gone to cleanse herself. فَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا رُوحَنَا. At that time when she was alone, we sent to her. Ruhana refers most likely to Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا سَوِيًّا. He came in front of her in the form of a man, a most handsome man, most pure man, most complete man. Seeing a man approaching her, finding herself all alone, she had never seen something. She was always in the precincts of the masjid. She was always protected by her uncle. قَالَتْ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِالرَّحْمَنِ مِنْكَ. Immediately she said, please do not approach me. I seek the protection of Allah from you. إِن كُنْتَ تَقِيًّا. Have the fear of Allah, do not come. Jibreel alayhi salam comforted her. إِنَّمَا أَنَا رَسُولُ رَبِّكَ. I am a messenger from the side of your Allah. لِأَهَبَ لَكِ غُلَامًا زَكِيًّا. I have come to give you as a gift, a most pure child. Maryam radiallahu anha, she had already seen miracles. She had seen the miracle of fruits coming to her out of season. When asked, where are these fruits coming? So innocently she would reply, هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. Does it not come from Allah? Allah gives how He wants. But this miracle was too much for her. She also would say, أَنَّا يَكُونُ لِي غُلَامٍ. How can I get a child? وَلَمْ يَمْسَسْنِي بَشَرٍ. No man has ever touched me, meaning through nikah. وَلَمْ أَكُ بَغِيًّا. And I have not gone to any man out of nikah. قَالَ كَذَلِكَ. The same answer was given. It will happen just like that. قَالَ رَبُّكِ هُوَ عَلَيَّ هَيِّنٌ. Your Lord says that it is indeed most easy for him. وَلِنَجْعَلَهُ آيَةً لِلنَّاسِ. And we will make him a sign for mankind. Nabi Isa alayhi salam was going to be a sign in many aspects. In the one aspect, the lesson that we are taking, when Almighty Allah wants an individual to stand, even if conditions around him are not muwafiq, are not suitable for his standing, there is nothing what the world knows as sabab and as sabab, cause and effect. There is no cause, apparent cause on the outside. The people will ask, how will it suddenly stand? The answer is kadalik. It will stand in the manner how Yahya alayhi salam was just created by the command of Almighty Allah. How Isa alayhi salatu wasalam was brought out by the command of Almighty Allah. قَالَ كَذَلِكَ. It will happen just like that. قَالَ رَبُّكَ. Your Lord says, هُوَ عَلَيَّ هَيِّن. What is difficult for Almighty Allah? فَحَمَلَتْهُ. Maryam radiallahu anha falls pregnant. فَانْتَبَذَتْ بِهِ مَكَانًا قَصِيًّا. Now she is becoming worried. The time is coming when she can feel the weight. How is she going to give birth in front of people? wondering what will the people say? How will she be able to explain to them that an angel had come to her in the form of a man? A gift was given to her. It was something the world had never heard about. As the world had never heard about an individual coming without any support, without any father, yet a son, a boy is being born into the world. Similarly, if the world says, I have never ever heard of a ruler just popping out from nowhere, just standing up and the whole world being invited, being attracted, falling at his feet, pledging the allegiance. The answer was given that having not heard of it before doesn't mean it is out of the qudrat of Almighty Allah. فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَىٰ جِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ The pains, birth pains, forced her to move to a palm tree. قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا Finding herself all alone, not knowing how will she go back to the people and explain to them what had happened. She said, if only I died before this. وَكُنْتُ نَسْيًا مَنْسِيًا I was something completely forgotten. No one even knew me. فَنَادَاهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا Jibreel alayhi salam would call out from below, أَلَّا تَحْزَنِي Do not have any worry. قَدْ جَعْلَ رَبُّكِ تَحْتَكِ سَرِيًا He says, have you not seen? Just look down and you will see there's a lovely, there's a spring of fresh water. Almighty Allah arranged it for you. That water will come to you. وَهُزِّي إِلَيْكِ بِجِذْعِ النَّخْلَةِ Says, look at the tree where you have fallen, where you reached and now you are tired. Just move slightly and you will see تُسَاقِطْ عَلَيْكِ رُطَبًا جَنِيًا The tree will drop upon you the freshest of dates when your Allah has sent food for you, when your Allah has sent drink for you. فَكُلِي وَشْرَبِي Then enjoy, eat and drink. وَقَرِّ عَيْنَا And having understood that your Allah did not leave you hungry in this condition, He did not leave you thirsty in this condition. وَقَرِّ عَيْنَا Then relax and understand your Allah is not going to leave you also in the future. As you will move amongst the people, your Allah will see to your needs. فَإِمَّا تَرَيِنَّ مِنَ الْبَشَرِ أَحَدًا If any man comes to you later and he says, where did this child come from? فَقُولِ Then answer, make an indication to him. إِنِّي نَذَرْتُ لِلرَّحْمَنِ صَوْمًا That I have made a pact with my Allah to fast today. In the previous Sharia when they were fasting, they were not going to talk during the day. She said, I am fasting. فَلَنْ أُكَلِّمَ الْيَوْمَ إِنْسِيَا Today I cannot talk. Such help comes from Almighty Allah's side that the individual also, if he doesn't want to talk, even in his silence there will be bayan. فَأَتَتْ بِهِ قَوْمَهَا تَحْمِلُ She now takes Nabi Isa alayhi salam, carrying him, she comes to her people. They gather around him. They become angry. They began taunting and shouting at her. Someone is saying, Ya Maryamu, لَقَدْ جِئْتِ شَيْئًا فَرِيًّا What a terrible thing you have committed. Ya أُخْتَ هَارُونَ مَا كَانَ أَبُوكِ امْرَأَسَوْ She says, O sister of Harun. Sister of Harun most likely was a title given. Harun most likely was someone very pious in her family. Whatever it was a name or a title that was given to her. They said, O أُخْتَ هَارُونَ Sister of Harun. Your father was not an evil person. وَمَا كَانَتْ أُمُّكِ بَغِيًّا Your mother was not a filthy woman. How did you go and do such an act? Maryam radiallahu anha, trusting on Almighty Allah, فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ She makes an indication to Nabi Isa alayhi salam. قَالُوا They become more angry and they say, كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ صَبِيًّا Someone who's in the cradle, do you expect us to speak to him? قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهِ Nabi Isa alayhi salatu wasalam answers on behalf of his mother. From the cradle he will speak. Miracle after miracle. It was an indication to the world, especially for the time that we are living, when Almighty Allah makes a decision, then according to that decision, the entire system will stand. If there is no apparent cause, it means nothing for the Qudrat of Almighty Allah. When the decision of Almighty Allah will come, everything will start happening. A child can start speaking in the cradle. Atani al-kitab. He gave me the book. He made me a nabi. Waj'alani mubarakan aynama kuntu. He made me full of blessings. Wherever I go, what I touch will get blessings. What I look at will get blessings. Over what I rub my hand will get blessings. What I point to will get blessings. Wa awsani bis-salati waz-zakati ma dumtu hayya. He ordered me with salah, with zakah, as long as I'm alive. وَبَرًّا بِوَالِدَتِي, he ordered me to be most kind, most obedient to my mother. وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا, he did not make me an evil person. وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ, in this manner, Nabi Isa alayhi salam gives his bayan from the cradle. His mother is a woman of a miracle. Nabi Isa alayhi salam stands as a miracle. Almighty Allah says, ذَلِكَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمُ, this was the beginning of Isa alayhi salam. قَوْلَ الْحَقِّ, this is the truth in which up till today some of them have doubt. مَا كَانَ لِلَّهِ أَن يَتَّخِذَ مِن وَلَدٍ سُبْحَانَهُ, the Christians later would come and say, he is the son, he is the son of God. Almighty Allah says, where did Almighty Allah need to take a son? Subhana, Allah is pure from all of that. Almighty Allah, as he created all people through a father and a mother at a time when both were in season, Almighty Allah then also creates through a father and a mother when both are out of season. And Almighty Allah sometimes created from a woman without a man. There is no season for Almighty Allah. Everything, إِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا, when Almighty Allah wants a matter to happen, فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ, it is only that he says, happen, فَيَكُونُ, and the entire thing stands. In the past, in Islamic history, when the world could not see how a revolution will take place, when the Crusades had gone and made, had collapsed the entire Muslim world of Sham, in the entire Sham, a masjid could not be found in which the name of Almighty Allah was taken. It was church upon church. Four Christian kingdoms stood up at that time when the Muslims on one side were having their fights amongst themselves. And then the Shia Fatimi Empire was extremely strong and it itself was crushing into the Muslim Ummah. If a person at that time looked and wondered, how will it ever stand? It was as though he was finding that there is a mother, there is a father, but both of them are out of season. They have lost all their power. There was still a surat when Almighty Allah made the decision. Salahuddin al-Ayyubi, rahimullah, changed the pages of Islamic history. He shocked the entire world of the Christians. Up till today, they also have written biographies regarding his life. He showed what is called the Qudrat of Almighty Allah. At a time where no one ever has thought, the Tatars had gone wild through the Muslim Ummah. Baghdad had been collapsed, which was the center of the Islamic world. When the world looked at the Tatars and it was said that this is a power that shall never be defeated, that was a time when no one ever thought Almighty Allah will establish someone. At that time rose such an empire which was going to become known as the mighty Ottoman Empire. Before that empire rose and started, if anyone was told that this is the beginning of a revolution, he would have shaken his head. And he would have said, there is no way the world is going to see now a revolution. One command of Almighty Allah and an empire stood up, the like of which the world had never seen before. Constantinople, which was never conquered until that moment, was also going to fall at the feet. When Almighty Allah will make the decision, Sayyidina al-Mahdi will also stand up in a similar condition. Without any suburb around him, without any apparent cause, it will just be the command of Allah, إِذَا قَضَى أَمْرًا, when Allah makes a decision, فَإِنَّمَا يَقُولُ لَهُ كُنْ, all it is he says to it, happen, and suddenly it happens. Some Sikh people have asked that when Sayyidina al-Mahdi will stand, then how will he make decisions? How will he make his rules? Where will he study before this military warfare? Where will he study how to bring parties together, armies together, how to attack? He is not in the advanced field of today's technology to understand how missiles work, to understand how their bombs work, to understand the delicate nature or the delicacies, the delicate, the intricate details of all the technology and the advancements in military power that they have made. How will he make a decision, shoot in this direction, knock them in that direction? Even if he had studied normal warfare, it would be regarding on a small battlefield. For him to have all the details, Almighty Allah then says, وَذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ إِبْرَاهِيمِ, then make mention of Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam. إِنَّهُ كَانَ صِدِّيقًا نَبِيًّا, indeed he was most truthful. He was a Nabi, a messenger of Almighty Allah. إِذْ قَالَ لِأَبِيهِ, remember that the time when he said to his father, oh my father, why is it that I find you worshipping something that cannot hear, that cannot see, that cannot help you at all? If someone had to say to Ibrahim alayhi salam at that moment, who taught you this here? You grew up finding your father worshipping the idol. A child grows up according to the mizaj and nature of his parents. Whatever he finds them doing, it settles in the mind that this is right. What language he finds his parents speaking, that becomes his language. What deen he finds his parents on, that becomes his deen. Where does a small child ever look at his father and he says, oh my father, I find whatever you are doing is wrong. It is against the demands of logic. Rather, you should do something else. If someone had asked Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam, where did you get this from? At that young age already, he said to his father, Inni qad ja'ani min al-ilm ma lam ya'tika. O my father, such knowledge has reached me, which has not yet come to you. Fattabi'ni, why don't you follow me? A young boy saying to a big person, a child saying to a father, he says, why don't you follow me? Ahdika siratan sawiya. I will show you how to get back onto the path. O my father, do not follow, do not worship the devil. Verily, the devil has completely disobeyed Almighty Allah. O my father, I fear that a punishment from Rahman will hit you. فَتَكُونَ لِلشَّيْطَانِ وَلِيًّا. You will become the friend of the devil. His father would become angry. But in that Ibrahim alayhi salam gave a message to the world. When people will want to know, how will the Mahdi make decisions? Then as the knowledge reached every Nabi of Allah, as a knowledge reached a young Ibrahim in the house of his father, he said, that knowledge reached me, O my father, which never reached you. Almighty Allah will inspire the Mahdi. He will make every decision that will be Ain, full, 100% on target, and he will shock the entire world. He will send shivers running through the worlds of kufr. On his hands, Allah Tabarak Tala will establish a new empire, a Muslim empire. It is that empire that we wait for, that we crave, we desire, we make dua. May Allah Tabarak Tala let it be that we are happy on the day that the call is made for that empire. It should not be when that call is made, we are the first ones at that time who pull back and we say, so quickly it happened. Why did it happen now? Why could it not have happened after a good couple of years? Now I cannot enjoy my family anymore. I cannot enjoy the comforts of my house anymore. When Islam becomes the maqsad of a person's life, when it becomes the main part of his life, then to die in order for an Islamic flag to be risen, to be raised high in the world, becomes an honor. It becomes a pleasure for an individual. Study when the Muslims, when the Ottoman Empire were on the verge of taking over Constantinople, because of their tanks and the boulders that they shot against the mighty walls which were surrounding the city of Constantinople, a hole finally was created. But now you needed someone to go through that hole. Running towards that walls, you would have people shooting, raining upon you arrows. You would have boiling water coming from the top falling. Whatever way the Christians could keep you out, they would try to keep you out. You would only be shielded with your own shield and the armor on your body. And now as you start running, you will find arrow upon arrow raining upon you. Getting through that hole, the individuals who ran, they understood that besides death, nothing else is going to meet them on that way. But it was a maqsad for them that to get this flag planted in the city of Constantinople on the top. Because with the planting of that flag, it would be an announcement that the Muslims have finally entered the city. The individual who reached where he needed to reach to plant the flag, historians have written that when he was found martyred. And he was found with so many arrows on his body. But for him it was a pleasure to be able to put down that flag, even if it meant that my life will go in it. Because the life was nothing for him. The flag of Islam was everything. When the call of the Mahdi will be made, it is this lesson that we need to bring in our hearts before that call. That for the flag of Islam to be raised in the world, for the system of Islam to become ghalib and dominant in the world, that is such an important maqsad, that for that maqsad, even if my life has to be taken, if my comfort zone has to be broken, if separation from my family has to occur, oh Allah, let it be that I am ready for it. Oh Allah, let it be that I move forward towards it. At that time when the call is made, let me not become a coward. Let me not pull back. Let the traits of nifaq not show itself on that day. O Allah, bless us all with true iman. O Allah, save us all from the traits of nifaq. In Surah Maryam, Almighty Allah made a great indication that when the decision of Almighty Allah comes, then whether there is an apparent cause or there is no cause, it is just one command of Almighty Allah and everything will start. We all wait for that command. And when everything starts, may Almighty Allah let us all be prepared. Wa akhiru da'wana. أن الحمد لله رب العالمين